When the bombing of the Gaza Strip began on the 7th of July, the population was already suffering a severe economic crisis caused by Israel's blockade on Gaza. The stated aim of Operation Protective Edge is to halt rocket attacks by Hamas and to destroy tunnels into Israel. In reality, it is civilians unable to flee this narrow piece of land who have been the main victims. Several UN-run schools, designated protection areas, have been shelled. Al-Shifa Hospital too has been hit. 25 medical structures have been damaged to date. Thousands have been injured. The teams at Al-Shifa Hospital were overwhelmed and an MSF team arrived to provide support 10 days after the start of the offensive.
We haven't seen such levels of shelling and destruction before. And the medical teams were extremely concerned about the numbers of victims they'd find in the streets, keeping the operating room running around the clock, and so on. MSF teams working through the night to relieve the Ministry of Health staff who were exhausted, but who had continued working, doing an amazing job.
Multiple injuries, burns, shrapnel wounds. The majority of patients are women and children, arriving in successive waves and in numbers outweighing the surgical capacity. The teams have been working relentlessly in order to respond to the most urgent cases. On the 5th of August, Israel pulled its ground troops out of Gaza as part of a ceasefire brokered in Egypt.
So we're planning the next stage. We have specialised staff and are going to suggest to the Ministry of Health that we focus on reconstructive surgery, particularly for burn victims, of which there are many, and also to continue working in the intensive care unit and to reinforce post-operative care.
Two days after the start of the ceasefire, the 520,000 displaced people started to go back to their homes, the majority of them to find little more than a pile of rubble.